Well, a very good afternoon to you from Ellesmere Port. There's one good thing about the wind, it does keep away the rain. Well, of course, it's day one of the new football season today. Day three of the Bass Masters, and we've already had some of our magic moments. In fact, we're going to start with one and take it from there. Stan Frith against Mark Britton, commentators Brian Brett and Hugh Johns.
Looking to make a contact. It's gone offline a bit. Just done it! Yes! Oh, what a superb delivery. Well, a single then to Stan. 16-17.
Well, it was asking a lot, wasn't it? All the way across, corner to corner. And anything through, he'd have been in the ditch. Seemed to go off course, then held its line, took the jack. What a single.
Stan sets off into that corner again. The ball took quite a bump as he delivered it. I wonder if it's done anything to the weight. Yes, it looked as though it took some of the running off it.
He waved it on, Hugh, as it hit that little bump. But that's a guy. I mean, if Mark avoids the bump, then perhaps his ball can work enough to come back. But he's too low.
Yes, I think he'll need a Fortney bus ride to come back from there. And there's that bump again.
Yep, he's on the road though, isn't it? If his length is better. It's not.
No, it isn't. Just a little hillock in front of the footer, which was catching Stan Frith's bowls. Mark Britton has avoided the bump. And as long as he gets past the blue one, he counts. Has he or hasn't he? It's a slight mathematical decision now on basically with triangles and angles.
Just had a feeling then that Frank Kitchen had made his mind up. Did you detect the blue lollipop?
I thought I saw a flash of blue there. Mm. And I know we say it so often that Frank is a good judge. The right-hand pocket, yes, one it is. Seventeen across. And Stan looks down to the corner just below us to set a mark of extreme length. There's something 45-ish, 46-ish perhaps yards, might even be a fraction longer than that. It's certainly a very long way. That is a very, very good lead for that distance. Britton certainly seems to have the road, but he needs that on a piece of string to pull it back because it's on its way to the ditch. Well, this would be a time to score a two. That's a couple of good bowls there. And Mark Britton has really got to take some running off his second delivery against his first. It stayed out, well out. Two to Stan Frith. 19-17. And the importance of that bowl at 15-17, Brian, becomes even greater, doesn't it? That
absolutely
superb long nickaway bowl.
One of the shots of the championship. The previous end, of course, the jack had gone off with Stan holding. at short, but Alyssa Loverby run since then. Four successive points over the last three ends.
Well, that Jack, solitary as it looks on the screen, is a mere speck in the distance to the bowlers from the mat. It's way over in the corner. There's a little downhill finish over there, so the ball can run just a little bit more, as it did. This easily the longest jack that we've had in this game. Curling around behind, and will keep on running, and is in the ditch. This is the requirement for delicacy here. You've got to get the weight to get up over the top of the crowd, but not too much as to keep on running as you come down the hill in this corner. Stan will be happy enough about that. He's holding one, and his second bowl is still on the green. Mark Britton, the game is against him. He's chasing that bowl. It's not going to arrive. It's not going to get there. Two, and that's it. Well, a fabulous run out then of six chalks by Stan Frith. The back end of that game, he took charge completely and puts out Mark Britton. In some style, 21-17.
Yes, Stan going along quite well. And that almost completes the second round from the top half of the draw. The first three quarter finalists are now known. John Bancroft, the championship favourite, Ron Stanford, and of course Stan Frith going through there, but not without a problem or two against Mark Britton. Well, that leaves Frank Rathall against Jane Jones, the first lady to go beyond the first phase in the history of the Bass Masters, and very much in contention against Frank Rathall after being 11-3 down at one point. So Jane battling back well. It's now becoming a question of stamina and concentration. Commentators Roy Ormson and Hugh Johns.
So the 18th end, 13-12. Jane Jones leads for the first time against this left-hander from Huddersfield, Frank Rothall. And Jane started to do the damage in the corners. Frank built his early lead on a mark just in front of the bowl set and the marquee, leading 9-3. All the way back, Jane came in the corner. She's taking the men on at their game. Leads 13-12. Just waiting for referee Wilf Oak to indicate just who is on. He doesn't know. She's got to play up. Very close. Long, long mark. They can't go much further in that corner. And she's sailing through, needs a connection, doesn't get it. So Frank Rothall, final bowl, 18th end. Seems to have missed the road. Well, if they couldn't decide before, then we may well have a measure. We've had two or three already this morning, and they've gone the way of Jane. A very, very strong comeback. Little break measure of six, please. In the corners. They're calling for a measure. As ever, the measure is the furthest point from the green. On the left, Frank Lomax, the Cheshire president, Cheshire Crown Green Bowling Association president. On the right, ex-petty officer Joe Owen from Sale, Manchester. Important end, Roy, isn't it, at 13-12. If you can just get a bit of daylight here, Roy Ormson.
Yes, she's done extremely well, and I think what's enabled her to do that is that she's overcome the early nerves, which has been the downfall of many of the ladies at the Bass here. And she's jogging after her bowls, which is a way of releasing a little bit of that tension, and it's very good. She's looking good, and she's leading well again, which is very, very important.
Long, long measure. In time, if not distance. Checking again. loads of interest, good support here for Jane in particular. Big family interest, local girl. From Heswall, just down the road, from here at the Woodland Hotel in Whitby, Ellesmere Port. Very, very close measure. Are they going to split them? We try again. And of course, a bit of money involved, the odd wager going on.
Has it got the blue ball?
Yes, it's resolved.
Rothall!
Well, Frank Rothall gets the verdict. And how he needed it. All smiles now, no wonder. They're level. 13 across. Interesting, Roy, that the man has elected not to test the lady in the full corners again.
No, he's coming just underneath the crown. Frankie's playing his finger peg, which of course is the right-hander's thumb, about 35 yards, and he's got a very good ball going here, just about a foot short of the jack.
Yes, good lead. Jane, this looks as though it's sailing through. Difficult conditions. Very windy this morning. We've had overnight rain. The green in parts seems to be a little bit sticky, and others it is running well. Frank looking to couple up. Oh, he's holding two.
Frank's using his left hand here, Brian. He's just pulling the ball in with his left hand, making it a little bit awkward for Jane.
Now she's taking some running out of this bowl. Giving it a chance. Giving it every chance. No, couldn't finally get over the final ridge. But she cuts it just to the one. Single. Frank Rothall. 14-13. The Rothall advantage. He's being made to pick his way around the green. He may well have settled on a plan early on. He built a good lead on a nice mark he found to go 11-3 ahead. Since then, Jane has come back very, very strongly. Now, this is some running, Roy, hasn't it? Down the brew. Unless he got a connection like that, he could have been a little bit through.
Yes, I think he'd have been about 4 or 5 feet past there. And I think Frank's game plan now, he's going to make the maximum possible use of the jack, and he's going all around the green, making use of it and testing Jane, and she's found a good ball here.
She's got the answer. Excellent. Well, the same bowl for Frank can pay rather nice dividends. He can rest out the yellow disc bowl, but he's off the road. No. No, well through. Good chance for two. Same bowl. Now then, the line okay. What about the length? Can he get down and down? Not enough.
Jones won.
Good single. We're all square again. 14 across. And like Maureen Bresnan, who yesterday built an early lead against Phil Carouche on the way to that historic first win by a lady over a man in the bus, she was well behind. Jane Jones struggled to find a game early on. The nerves had to be conquered, but now she looks in control. She needs a good lead. They like it. They like it. Yes. Rothall. Good line. The weight will just carry him through.
And you have to say, Brian, that tactically it's very sound. Jane's very, very sound here. She's going into the chamfered corner. If she gets in, she'll go about 40 yards up into the scoreboard corner.
Right, well, certainly holding one, possibly two. You get the feeling the second bowls are not going to figure in anything here. Desperate to get in now. 14 across, certainly one against him. Now it's all about weight. Not enough.
Jones
another
won.
Single. Jane Jones. 40-year-old housewife. Plays for Camel Lairds. Leads Frank Rothall from Huddersfield. 46-year-old toolmaker. 15-14. And as Roy Armstrong predicted, we're away into the country. Roy, this is almost as far as we've seen in the entire tournament. Just a couple of yards, maybe.
Very nice, Mark. Yes, it has to go through some of the lush part of the green. She's playing finger peg. It's about 40 yards. And Frank Rathall will have to draw on his experience now. He's got 33 county caps for Yorkshire, and he's going to need all that experience to topple this lady.
Well, a good lead, and the bowl has turned over and settled, so it'll be difficult to dislodge. Rathall all the way across the green, corner to corner. Working hard, trying hard, can't do it. Well, makes life a little bit difficult. Jane, just wanting to know who is on, and it goes her way. She's lying with one, a little bit of danger. And that she wants to steer well clear of the Rothall bowl, but still be far enough. Extreme care, possibly too much caution, but it's safe. Now, Rothall can certainly afford to put some running into the bowl, but has he? Are we far enough? No, give him up. Oh dear. They will wait for Rothall to arrive, but it's certainly another single. Jane Jones. 16-14. Jane Jones. Jane, very busy lady. She won that huge tournament, the Ladies Waterloo, that Mary Ashcroft, the referee, helped to form and found years ago. 40-year-old housewife. Plays with Camel Lairds, just down the road here. Been playing for 10 years. Now then, is this another good lead? I think it'll do. It's pulled up just about a yard short, but it's bang on the road. Rothall could be better. Is better. Good length bowl. Good bowl. Long, long mark set by Jane Jones. 23rd end. The whistling it through, needs a hit. He's got it. Oh, Roy, that was almost in the River Mersey. That was really flying.
Well, they say never up, never in. It was a brave bowl, and she got the right connection, but she could have promoted her own just as well, but this is a bad bowl.
This is a bad one from Frank.
Jones won.
Well, another single. What a run. Four successive singles. Jane Jones taking her from 14-13 down to a lead of 17-14. And no need to change the land, Roy. She's punishing these corners.
Yeah, she's really playing well. And danger signals are on the horizon for Frank Rathall now, because she's within two ends of game. He's really got to do something here. He's got to make sure he reaches. His last end, he was short. He must reach that jack.
Well, I think this is a little off the road. The important thing now is to conquer these nerves again. The nerves she had early in the game got her off to a terrible start. But now, you know, within sight of the winning post, the old butterflies are there again. Now Rothall. He needs all that experience, that county experience. 18 years a bowler, he's short. Hopelessly short. Well, Jane started off by beating Hazel Pashley, 21-16 in the first round, breaking away from 12 across. This now needs a good correction and gets it. Certainly that's the winner at the moment. Rich applause. Good crowd here already at the Woodland. Plenty of support for the lady. Rothall, he's further than his second bowl, but he's no better than Jane Jones.
One.
Another single. Well, are we about to see history repeated? 18-14, Jane Jones. And again, just moving the jack around a shade, but heading back towards the public house, a little shorter than last time. All about leading. She has invariably led well, but she has corrected brilliantly with her second bowl when needed. They like this. No wonder. Absolute dead length. Well, Roy, if there's any reward for practice, then she's getting it now.
Yes, she's cleverly. She's shortened the jack here. She's 2 yards shorter with the jack, and Frank looks as though he's going through the gap. Oh. Those people that have made a financial investment will be doing very well here, because Jane Jones was 2-1 to win this game. Yes. Frank Rathup was 3-1 on. What an upset.
Well, an upset on the cards, but out on the green. She's going to couple up. She's here for two. She's here for two. She needs three for a win. The precious witches. It's all on Rathall. This the bowl. He needs it. It'll go through and out. Well, she's almost there. Almost there. 20-14. Roy, I've got to say that while yesterday's win by Maureen Bresnan was the first, the historic one, really this could be an even more difficult game and an even bigger achievement if Jane Jones can beat Frank Rathall.
I agree with you. Yes, she has played really, really well today, led extremely well, concentrated on her game, and she's looking good. And here she's got a good ball going here, just needs to run a little bit further, I think.
It's trying for her, Roy. She's listening to it. She's waving it on. She's urging it on. 2.5 foot short, but it's a long, long mark. Rothall's not only got to beat Jane Jones, he's got to beat a few hundred people around this green as well. They're urging her home for the second win by a lady, we hope. We all hope, of course, but we've got to be absolutely impartial, and we've got to feel for Frank. Not easy.
And his downfall, Brian, has been in short bowls. He's played too many short bowls on three occasions going in this direction. He's been short every time.
Well, she's won it on marks, twice the length of those set by Frank. Can it get past? No. She needs one. She holds one. And what that, in fact, has done has made it very difficult for Frank Rathall to find a way through. She leads at the moment, 20-14. She needs this one. Rathall knows it. She's only done it. She's done it.
Jones won.
Well, the handshake. History again. What a win. Tremendous. From 9-3 down all the way, Jane Jones becomes the second lady to beat a man in the Bassmasters this historic year, 21-14.
And the local heroine, Jane Jones, is with us now with her guru this week, Sister Pat. 11-3 down.
Yes, I thought
it was a historic win.
I really, 11-3 down, and I wasn't finding the length, I wasn't finding the land. And I just thought, well, he's going to have a good victory here. But once I got the jack and took him on a longer length, I put him under pressure.
Pat, were you helping out from greenside? Do you offer words of advice during the course of a game?
Well, first of all, let me say it was an absolute nightmare for me watching. Yes, when Jane was a yard short, or she needed, a bit more land, or I tried to help out, and but it's all down to Jane on the day. She bowled absolutely superb, and I'm really proud of her.
Just to remind all the folks at home that, of course, you would have been here but for Jane, because yep. It was an all-sister final in the ladies' Waterloo, which is extraordinary.
Well, it was a day to remember, for the whole family, and Jane bowled well at the Waterloo final, and I'm pleased for her that she's come here and she's performed so well, and she's done such a lot for the ladies' game of bowls here at the Bass.
And we've got another lady coming up this afternoon, Maureen yes. Bresnan, and surely she can't win as well.
Yes, she can. She's a very capable bowler, Maureen. She'll have to tighten the game a little bit to what she bowled yesterday, although she bowled well. But Chris McDonald's really bowled superb. But if Maureen bowls the way she can, she can beat him.
In a word, Pat, can the ladies win the Bassmasters?
Well, I'd like to think yes, but I'm just keeping my fingers crossed.
Thanks very much for joining us, the both of you. Well done again, Jane. We'll be back at 5 to 2 after the Satan Grievesy, and Maureen Bresnan will be part of that programme. Join us again.
She leads at the moment, 2014. She needs this one. Rothall knows it. She's only done it. She's done it.
Jones won.
Well, the handshake. History again. What a win. Tremendous. From 9-3 down all the way, Jane Jones becomes the second lady to beat a man in the Bassmasters this historic year, 21-14.
Yes, the ladies have certainly made their mark at this year's Bassmasters. Jane Jones going through to the quarterfinals, and that's never happened before. Well, joining me on a very windy balcony overlooking the green here at Ellesmere Port is the championship favourite, John Bancroft. These ladies are putting the frighteners on you fellas, are they?
They're playing very well, really. Jane's played a great game this morning. She's given the green a lot of sticks. She's really been giving it some practice in hours she's put in, and it's paid off for her. She's played very well.
Do you feel for the likes of Frank Ruffell and the circumstances like that, particularly when you consider he was 11-3 in front?
Well, for the last, I don't know how many years the women have been in, 3 or 4 years, it's been the one horror of all the fellas, really, to lose to a woman, and it's happened twice this week now with Phil and Frank.
And I suppose it could happen again, because out there on the green at the moment is Maureen Bresnan, first round winner, of course, against Phil Carouche from the Isle of Man. There's Maureen. She's putting up a good show here. 6-3 down against one of the former champions of the Bassmasters, Chris McDonald.
Yeah, Chris has played very well yesterday to get out of jail, really, with Gary Wallace. And I think he feels, having got through that game, that he fancies quite a good run in the competition.
I'll tell you what he fancies. He told me yesterday that he fancies you in the final. He wants revenge for the Waterloo, you know.
Well, I wouldn't mind playing Chris in the final. Every time we do play each other, it seems to be in big, important competitions, so it'd be nice to play him.
But you were his best man, I believe.
I was the best man at his wedding, yes. About 3 years ago now, yeah.
Well, he is 6-3 in front at the moment against Maureen. One final question, John, about the ladies. I mean, could they win a tournament such as this?
Well, now they've got to the quarter-final stage, I think Jane's probably gone against Frank Rathall with a relaxed attitude. Now she's got to the quarter-finals, the pressure will start to tell on her as well. And she's got a very tough draw in Stanforth, and I would imagine Stan will go through in that game, yeah.
Okay, well, Maureen's not doing badly at all, is she there? 6-4, and when you consider that Jane Jones was 11-3 down at one point against Frank Rathall, who knows? Smiling face of Maureen Bresnan as we join the very cheerful Mary Ashcroft and Hugh Johns.
Indeed, and thank you, Elton. We're wrapped up in this game, Mary and I, with what has already started something of a comeback for Maureen Bresnan. She was 6-1 down after six ends. She's clawed her way back, a double, a single, and a very, very good lead here with the block. Oh, no more than a foot from the ditch. Now, is that blue ball going to stay on? Blue ball is counting. She's got to be awfully careful here, Mary.
Yes, she has, but I feel that she's got to come for two if she possibly can, or come in front of it. Not as short as that, Maureen. Oh. She really has to cover up, because I feel Chris is going to have a go at this.
Well, a connection with anything down there, and you've got a dead end. You can either hit his yellow bowl onto the blue bowl. Hit the jack. Well, he's strong enough. Now then.
Now he's connection underneath. Slipping
in the ditch.
That's number one.
So Maureen gets a single. And appreciative applause from the huddled up audience here at the Woodlands, where we've had all kinds of weather this morning. The sun was out at one time, the rain was belting down at another time. It's warm weather clothing, but an audience thoroughly enjoying seeing this fine lady, Maureen Bresnan, grandmother, winner of the Wire Festival, to qualify for this tournament, where she's stood everything on its ears by taking out Phil Karush. It was a crash for Karush, 21-17. And here, she's already showing Chris McDonald, former winner of this tournament, that she's no easy meat. She is a lady of class and very, very good bowling ability. I think she fancies that she's in here. Will Folk confirms that the blue bowl is the one. So Chris, a little bit of work to do. Not going to arrive. Wait for Chris to confirm.
One
it is. So a break of five chalks in a row, and Maureen is level. It's the direction that she set the block the end before last, but this time not quite so far.
It's good bowl coming here, Hugh. Very good lead.
That is a beauty, isn't it? Chris has a contact here. What a beautiful contact.
Good bowl, Chris.
Road doesn't look bad. Doesn't look bad. Yes!
What a good bow. It just had to be the right speed, didn't it, just to catch it.
What's Chris's reply?
Well, I hope he's not short.
If he turns his own bowl over, I think he's in. He has turned it over.
That's gone all the way.
Yes, that was... There were four absolutely magnificent bowls on that end. And the victor at the end, a single for Chris McDonald. The wind has been very brisk here throughout the course of the day. It's actually dropped for a moment or two, which is a pity, because need a bit of wind to dry this green out. You were down there refereeing, Mary, a short while ago. Those... squalls of rain that we had have taken some of the running out, haven't they?
Yes, they've made it a bit patchy as well, which is a bit awkward for the players. Well, that's better land, Maureen. The bowls are holding a little bit. Where the dark green patches are in the hollows, the bowls are holding a little bit.
And that... that corner over there is tricky enough as it is. And now suddenly shafts of sunshine coming out to help dry the well-trimmed grass here at the Woodlands. That line looks jolly good. What about the weight? Yes.
Takes the lead. Takes the lead.
8-7. The grandmother from the Wirral gets in front. This, of course, is no new thing for Chris McDonald. You look back on his game in the previous round against Gary Wallace. He was actually in front only twice in the whole of that game. The very first end when he scored a single, and the very last end when he won it 21-20. Maureen. Not quite online. Oh, yes, she is. Yes, that's trickling down the hill beautifully. And the audience here is absolutely enthralled with this game. As you can see, there's just a few empty seats. So if you want to come down here and join us, what is it, 2:05? You can get here in a few minutes. You can still enjoy this fascinating game of bowls and the others that are coming. But if you have to stay at home, you are seeing it as it happens.
Maureen's on a good line again. She just needs to touch her own bowl, really. Yeah, it's fine. How about that?
Absolutely knockout.
You're one down. A 4-inch.
And isn't she enjoying it? I think there's some heavy ammunition coming down. Watch out. Yes, that's a contact. Taken it out. That's a beautiful strike. Taken the shot ball out as clean as a whistle and leaves his own yellow ball there to count. So, alive. That was a marvellous strike, wasn't it? Absolutely bang on the button.
Yes, it was brilliant. I think we can expect a lot of this from Chris. Maureen gets these balls too close. She's got to leave that little gap.
Yes, they always say that if you leave a gap, it's 10 to 1, your opponent's going to find it and go flying through it. Ah, we're going for
tactic change.
A little curly mark. Very, very round peg. Oh, what a beauty. Bowling up to allow slope to help the bias. That looks a little bit heavy. Only about 8 to 10 inches long. But on this particular mark, using the slope and the bias of the bowl will come down in a great big swinging arc.
Only one.
Just one. Now, it's got to be a bowl of perfection, of delicacy, of accuracy.
Yeah,
that's too heavy. That's never coming back.
Yeah. Wrong bowl, that.
One for Chris McDonald.
I feel that was a case of turning your bowl over there, really. Just playing that little through shot. Chris has started to think about the game, Hugh, don't you think?
I'm just going to say, she's. I think she's got at him a little bit here. Mm. He realises he's got no easy ride.
That's right, and he's got to think of something different. It's coming nice.
Oh, delightful lead.
Well, Maureen, what are you doing?
Just underneath it. Mm. Oh. Chris would dearly love, I think, to be behind here now. Just behind. Too far behind. Now.
Maureen.
she brave enough to have a go? No, it's just a tiny bit of extra running in the bowl. But no, that's going to be underneath. No.
MacDonald won.
I think a lot of people might have felt that she could have gone with some weight there and had a bang at that, Maureen. But I mean, in general terms, ladies don't really have that hard firing shot as part of their armoury.
Well, there's not many do. One or two have a try, and there's quite a few that will play through. And I'm a bit surprised at Maureen because she is one that will do that. And yet, obviously, the last two ends when it should have been done, she's not tried it. Oh, good lead, Chris.
Chris MacDonald qualifying through the Goodyear Open. Beat Steve Copeland in the semi-final that day, and the day that Steve became a father, and then went on to beat Ivan Williams in the final. Chris may very well have found a little mark here that he's going to pay rich dividends for him.
There's only two in front, you know.
Love your loyalty and supreme optimism, Mary.
One, yes.
She's turned the bowl over. And it didn't pay dividends.
No, it won't. It won't peg uphill. A bowl.
So, a little break of four chalks for Chris MacDonald. And he's 11-8 in front. And sees no reason to change the piece of land that he's claiming as his own territory at this moment.
Just changing his length that little bit each end. And that little touch further with this. Good bow again. Good lead.
Delicate touch for a very big man. Road's good. Deserve better. Pushing it out on a wide, wide piece of land. Now it runs down the hill. Ah, it's a beauty. Well, surely, Maureen, you've got to show whether you have a firing shot in your ammunition. Yes, Wilf Oak finally did get the message. What about it?
Ooh.
Oh, so close. But, as they say, so close and yet so far. And that's a double for Chris. And a 13-8 advantage. And it's beginning to look, Mary, as though Maureen Brisnan's run of triumphs against men in this tournament could be on its way to an ending.
Yes, I think she's got to steady herself down a little bit and think about a shot before she sends it. She's just going off a mat a little bit fast.
Well, another squall of rain has referee Wilf Oak now sheltering under an enormous umbrella. Yes.
Good ball.
Found it. And it just settles down and kisses the jack delicately on its arrival.
Yeah, Chris's bowl is in his own way if he wants to, you know, play a little through shot.
Well, he's taken a walk about 10, 15 yards off the mat to see the lie of the land. Is that too tight? Yes, it is. And come again, Maureen, are the encouraging words coming out from the crowd.
going in for two as well, isn't it?
Get past the yellow ball. No, it pulled up. I don't think it has. Maureen will be disappointed when she gets there to see how close she got to scoring two. One only.
And the sun shines again.
I wonder if that's an omen for Maureen Bresnan. A bowler for, 30? 31, 32 years. And the chap she's playing against, 26 years old. But then, he's been bowling some time. He started when he was only 9, started by his parents and many of his relatives who were bowlers. And they taught him well. Wasn't that a beauty?
He followed the golden rule, always cash in on your opponent's bad lead.
Come on. Maureen's lost the block.
McDonald won.
Well, he'd be well satisfied to have got that block back in his grasp. And a 5 shots advantage as the sun comes out to cast lovely shadows across this well-kept green here at the Woodlands. Just outside Ellesmere Port, in fact. I wonder if this sunshine will bring a number of you from your armchairs where you're watching it live to come here and actually taste the excitement and drama of the fine bowling that's going on here.
Here's the winning ball.
Well, bowl, Maureen. Unlucky, Chris. I'd have said those the yellow and the blue bowl are equidistant from the block, forming a perfect isosceles triangle, but we'll see in a moment. Oh, don't run it.
Oh dear.
I think that has changed things dramatically.
I'm afraid
it has. In fact, Chris might just be holding two here now.
She'll be disappointed at that one.
Pegs, please.
She will.
Pegs, please, he says. Which is the call then for Frank Lomax and Roy Bate to come out and sort out this situation. Are they going to measure all three?
I feel this is one instance she could have waited and asked the referee who was in anyway. She was unsure.
Reach that one as well.
And is it still in?
Bresnan one.
Yes.
And it is still.
Well, 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 well.
And a little bit of luck with that one.
Dramatic. 10-14. Off the mat, Maureen Bresnan. Coming down the hill.
And it's a good lead.
It's not a bad lead. Again, a round peg mark. Thumb peg. And Chris pushed that one out a little bit too far. And Maureen bumped that one away. What's that done to the running of the bowl?
Just taken that yard.
Yes, it has. You'd fancy Chris to make the right correction now. And it may well be that Maureen's chance has gone. Knocked her in closer. Only three in it.
I think whatever happens over this match and Jane Jones' quarter final, the men are going to have that little bit more respect for us. Don't you think?
I think you're right, Mary. I take your point. I think every man in this tournament was fearful that one of these days a lady would come along and just show him how it should be done. And it certainly happened. Certainly happened. And there'll be one or two red faces around after this tournament is over. Maureen, quite a lot of improvement to do on the running of her first bowl. The road looks well nigh perfect. Run a bit more, run a bit more, run a bit more. It's run far enough. That's won it.
Chris can't believe it.
Just favourite, just about won it.
Big Mac comes down to have a good look. How did she get there, he says. Very, very joyous smile on the face of Maureen Bresnan. I think there is a lady who you can honestly say has enjoyed every single moment of this tournament so far, Mary.
I'm sure she has. I'm sure. I mean, she's quite happy because she's bowling well, and this is the main thing, isn't it?
Watch out, the heavy ammunition of Chris McDonald. Missed. Well fielded by referee Will Folk. And Maureen scores another single.
Just feel the more he strikes, the more the crowd are going to get behind Maureen.
Well, in the flat game, where I've had a great deal of my original upbringing in the game of bowls, they will always tell you that when bowlers are striking and firing, it's a sign that they're losing their touch. They're losing their ability to draw and concentrate. And you've got them going if you keep pegging away at them. And I think Maureen is beginning to get to her. Well, that's pushed Maureen just 6 or 8 inches further forward, and Chris McDonald. He is absolutely furious with himself. Come on, Maureen, you need another couple of yards of running on this bowl.
Just get in front.
Just in front of the yellow bowl. Now, Chris will hide his face in shame if he doesn't creep past these three, surely. Found the gap and creeps right up onto the target. That'll make him feel a lot better. He pulls one back. He's in front, 15-12. Wonder where he'll be when you rejoin us again.
New Argos catalogue, take one.
Ooh.
Cut! 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 I said take one!
The new Argos catalogue is out now.
Attenzione, prego, questa è l'ultima chiamata.
nice to see you again. Oh, yes. Hasn't time flown?
Yes, it stood still for you. I have grey hair. You're not grey at all, are you?
That's because I look after myself. I discovered Just for Men. Simply apply, wait 5 minutes and rinse off. Grey hairs just disappear. With Just for Men, no grey, just natural-looking colour.
Your husband is so young-looking. Are you sure he and my Harry went to school together?
Just for Men gets rid of the grey in just 5 minutes.
Ah, I do enjoy these family get-togethers.
Gives one a good chance to catch up with everyone's financial wheeler dealing. Not that there's much of that in your family.
Well, actually, most of my lot with the Alliance and Leicester.
Shrewd financial acumen, Mustin. Cannot be acquired. It's inbred. You take my nephew Herbert. Now, he's as sharp as a button.
Key, where'd you get that?
Oh, I've got a cash plus account. I can save up, get cash out whenever I want.
Snack. My savings are in euro reversible trouser bonds.
So you're going to the party tonight?
I'll see if I can liquidise my assets.
How long will that take?
About 6 months.
Bye.
Kids!
Well, the Alliance and Leicester have always made saving simple for me. Even my granddad swears by them.
So I'll buy the special return account. Simply gives me very high interest.
Investment is never simple, Mustin. Ask my wise old grandfather. He stalks the stock exchange with the killer instinct of a coiled cobra.
See?
From 8 to 80. You get a smarter investor at the Alliance and Leicester.
Free! A great 24-page soccer fixtures guide for England, Wales and Scotland, plus the international matches. Also, your personal lottery number could win you fabulous prizes. Plus, in the big free magazine, superstar Bruce Willis talks about life, wife Demi Moore and his fears for their children.
Every kind of people, your kind of people.
Only in The People. Buy it on Sunday.
Now, for an amazing £5,599, you can get a very special edition Nova Spin. The Nova Spin, with 0% finance.
Now, this isn't just a fancy dress contest. It's a contest to show how much better fairy is than these less effective liquids. Mmm, lovely beef burger. Now, who shall we have? Well, we have to have you for fairy, don't we? Hello, hello, hello. You look as if you'll play fair to me. Mmm, lots of lovely bubbles to start with. But are they still shifting the grease?
Yuck, can't do any more.
Fairy bubbles can.
See, those other liquids can do this much. But fairy goes on to do 50% more than those lesser liquids. Yeah!
So you can tell us apart.
He sounds different.
Do I?
I see what you mean.
And as we've been continuing live while you've been away, you've missed two ends. Maureen Bresnan scored one, Chris McDonald scored one, and Chris McDonald is about to score another one. So that takes him on to a 17-13 lead. And the signs are looking just the tiniest bit ominous for Maureen and her chances of making further progress to the quarterfinals, Mary.
You've not got to give up hope yet, but at least she's put up a good show. Whatever happens, and it's certainly making Chris change his game. I don't think he knows what to do really. You, Luke. It's affected his game because he can't. If he's going on the short round peg and Maureen's winning, he's taken on a long mark and she's beat him. Now he's trying to cross the crown of the green and she's beat him here again. Come on.
Yes, I'm sure that Chris might have had a sleepless night last night thinking about this game, wondering what would happen. And she's pushed him and pushed him and pushed him. I think that may, although it's gone through, I think it may be the winning bowl at the moment. Now this is all about weight.
Well, she's got to connect with his bow.
Rest on it and she's in.
Yes.
1-1.
Only three chalks in it. And Maureen Bresnan, an insurance agent. Could do with a little bit more insurance than this. Three chalks down. She'd love to be three chalks in front. But she's got the block back. And who knows? A little run with that block now. She could get her nose in front. She's certainly got the talent to do it. She's shown us that already. It's not a bad lead at all. It's made Chris come down and have a look at the finish of this particular delivery. Waving it in.
Yes, it's coming down nice. Does it give up?
Well, put your money where you like on those two now. Six of one, half a dozen of the other. Now cut inside
Maureen's
it,
took
Maureen.
A different line. She's just getting inside. Good bowl, this.
Oh, yes, a beauty. Question is she holding one or two? What does Wilfolk think?
Yes, maybe for two, that second ball.
Yeah, it could be two. Chris. He's taken a tighter line.
Yeah, it's playing to save. Playing to save.
And it's gone right through, and Chris holds his
head. Can't believe it.
And the smile on Maureen's face. Chris can't believe that that gap was there, that he could get through it. But it's a double. The third time she scored a double in the match. She's closed the gap to just one. 16-17. Do we have something really dramatic again building up on this green? Maureen Bresnan, the first lady bowler in the Bass tournament to beat a man. When she took out Phil Kirush. Now is she going to dump Big Mac out? Can happen. Can happen.
She's going on a difficult mark. He'll slip by that.
Gone out. I tell you what, if Maureen picks up a double here,
it'll get the crowd buzzing.
Gracious me. Don't think it's got the legs to climb the hill. But it might be in the road. Chris absolutely pounding after this. And he found
the gap again.
Would you, Adam, and Eve it? Woof. One to Maureen Bresnan.
What's the score, you?
The score is, as you very well know, Mary, 17 across. What a match. Well, Mary, you and your ladies must be absolutely over the moon with the way this Bass tournament is going.
We really are. I mean, it's taken a few years to prove their worth, but by golly, this year they have done. At last. Oh, come on, Maureen, lass. Don't let us down now.
I think the excitement of that particular moment has coming over to me.
Yes, got a ball away too quick again.
Oh, woof! That's flown right out. It's a long way back. Oh, Maureen, she bumped that one down. Make a contact, or you'll fly out. Well, it's counting one, but surely Chris can do something about it. It's gone out.
I'm afraid
it's flown past. It's flown past.
To Maureen, come on.
That's another single for Maureen.
Come
and
on.
Look at Chris McDonald.
Where's the other one?
on.
He just can't believe it. Well, for live bowls on television, the drama of this particular game, I do believe we'll take some beating. 18-17. Maureen Bresnan is in front. There'll be very few people who would believe that. The wind swirling around here, and that's gone rather a long way past. Chris McDonald. Don't forget, he came from the dead to
this
beat Gary Wallace.
This bowl isn't short.
Now, Maureen, can she find the bowl that will put even more pressure on Chris? Oh no, that's never going to get there. It looks as though the drama of this particular match has at last really got to her. Chris, who came from the dead to beat Gary Wallace, looks as though he's got to come from behind again. And the relief on his face as he throws that mat down. A break of five chalks comes to an end as Chris McDonald picked up to 19-18. He leads. So Chris now, has he shaken off the traumas, the nervous tension, the pain that was going through him as Maureen Bresnan started to take him on and beat him? Has he been able to shake that off and snatch this game, or is Maureen going to come again? That's in the ditch unless it contacts. She needed to make that contact, but she had gone in the ditch.
She certainly did, and it's a good bowl there.
To beat that bowl, Chris, who has just this one delivery on this end, has got to be awfully careful. He could wind up in his ditch, in the ditch himself.
Yes. Anything past the blue bowl, obviously.
He's in the ditch. Now, a double is on for Maureen because she's only got a beat. A yellow bowl, which must be 8 to 9 feet from the jack. And Chris's face is a picture. Oh, no, it's not going to get there. Oh, what a chance wasted. A single, though.
Bresnan won.
19 across. The winning of this match could happen while you sit there watching it. In this very next end. Well, how about this for a game of bowls, Mary?
Well, I think it's fantastic. I really do. Good lead now. She's changed her tactics. She's gone straight peg.
And the sun comes out. Is it going to smile on Maureen Bresnan? Well, that's a fair old lead. Oh, Chris with some real hard work to do here. Oh!
What's he done? Come on, Maureen, couple up with this one.
If you get in tight with this, Maureen, you are going to pull off one of the great dramatic victories of all time.
And it's going well. Go on.
Perhaps it's not close enough.
She's got to play a saver. He can't afford to strike, can he?
Chris McDonald has not followed the bowl up.
He might run out with this, you know.
It's gone well past. Maureen's waving it through.
She's won.
I think she has. She looks down and she's taking the applause.
Yay!
The crowd are on their feet for again. High drama in the Bassmasters.
Too late.
Here live at the Woodlands Hotel. 21-19. Chris hasn't given it yet. Hang on a bit. Chris hasn't. He has now. Yes.
Where is
Chris McDonald is out. Well, Mary.
Where is this Tony Poole?
For those of you who don't remember it, Tony Poole said last year that ladies should not be in this tournament. He's got to swallow his words now. This lady has made it do it. Oh, brilliant stuff as Maureen gets the applause of the crowd and everybody in sight.
Well, that must surely go down as the biggest upset in the history of the Bass Masters. And don't forget, it's the 10th anniversary of the championship this year. Your reaction to that, John Bancroft?
That's the biggest upset I've ever seen involves that, without a doubt. I thought Chris would win quite comfortably, really, because he did play well yesterday at the end of the game. But Maureen there has played absolutely fantastic at the end. And because she's come back from being a few behind at one stage, Chris had got three or four chokes in front.
Now, what must Chris be feeling now?
He'll be gutted, I would think. He'll be on such a down, I would think, after that. I mean, she has played well, but I think in his heart of hearts, he'll have been expecting to win quite easily, I would think, really.
I mean, this really will send shockwaves through the men's game, this result, more than any other that we've seen this week.
Well, I think Mary Ashcroft said it earlier in the week, if they get one winner, they might get a few. Maureen Bresnan proved it earlier in the week, beating Phil Carouge. Jane Jones has gone and beaten Frank Rathall. Maureen's now gone and beaten Chris McDonald. Don't know where it's going to end.
Now, you'll be hoping you don't play her, I know that for certain. Anyway, a most dramatic afternoon here, and it's not over. We're back at 3:40 with more bowls from the Woodland Hotel. Well done, Maureen Bresnan.
Put your mind at rest. I'm not playing with your friend. I like Lena. I like her a lot.
The sun comes out. Is it going to smile on Maureen Bresnan? Yeah. Well, that's a fair old lead. Oh. Chris with some real hard work to do here. Oh!
What's he done? Come on, Maureen. Couple up with this one.
If you get in tight with this, Maureen, you are going to pull off one of the great dramatic victories of all time.
And it's going well. Go on.
Perhaps it's not close enough.
She's got to play a saver. He can't afford to strike, can he?
Chris McDonald has not followed the bowl up.
He might run out with this, you know.
It's gone well past. Maureen's waving it through.
She's won.
I think she has. She looks down and she's taking the applause.
Yay!
The crowd are on their feet for again. High drama in the Bass Masters.
Too late.
Here live at the Woodlands Hotel. 21-19.
Welcome back to the Bass Masters, and let's meet the lady who's turned the world of bowls upside down, Maureen Bresnan, who's beaten one of the favourites here, Chris McDonald, a little earlier on this afternoon. Maureen, very well done. You were saying a couple of moments ago that you were terrified from start to finish.
I really was, yes. Just trying to bowl well, and I know what a reputation Chris has got, and he's also won it once. And I just wanted to bowl well. If I could bowl as well as Jane had done this morning, I'd be quite happy. I'm thrilled to bits. I can't believe it. I just can't believe that I've struck 21.
They're saying around the place here that it is the biggest upset in the history of Crown Green Bowls.
Well, I did say last night I like to be the first to do anything. And if I can keep doing that, I'll be
believe
quite pleased.
Me, that's a first. Anyway, you better introduce us to the family.
Oh, this is my grandson, Graham. And he's lovely. And this is Mum, my daughter Catherine, and she was in tears when I won.
Well, Catherine, what was it like watching Mum out there?
Awful. I'm just glad she's off the green and she's got 21. It was terrible watching. I'd rather be playing.
You do play yourself, do you?
Yes. Oh, yes. Yes, little bit.
I was going to say, yes. Kevin, he's an excellent bowler.
Excellent bowler, yes. He's played Chris a couple of times and not beaten him, so that's one up on the son-in-law. So I'm quite pleased about that, too, yeah.
I'm glad you're not my mother-in-law, then.
Oh, I don't think he'll go off me, no. Don't think he'll go off me.
Now, what about Graham? Are you going to play bowls when you're a bit older, like Granny and Daddy?
I hope he is, because he's a little left-hander.
Is he?
Yes, left-hander and... they're a devil to play.
Now, has it sunk in yet?
Yes, I think so. I think so. Yeah, I'm absolutely thrilled to bits. Thrilled to bits, and especially for my mum. My mum's here. She's 83 and she follows me around the bowls and she's ecstatic.
Well, obviously you're not going to win the tournament.
You want a bet? I've got that 200 down to 100. I'll get it further down. Those bookies got me mad.
You really believe you can win this, don't you?
I'd like to see Jen and I in the final. I can't really see it, but I would like it.
I must admit, I can't remember who you've got in the next round.
No, I don't know. I don't know. I think it could be the winner of this game here.
That's right. It's going to be the winner of either Ken Strutt or Barry Kitson.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thoughts on?
I just
hope
they're more nervous than me.
Anyway, well done. Absolutely marvellous afternoon that you provided everyone with some splendid entertainment.
Thank you very much.
It was a privilege to see that game, Maureen.
Thank you
really
very
was.
Much indeed. Thank you.
Let's see some more bowls. Follow that, as they say.
And the match that you now join is the one that decides who plays against Maureen Bresnan in the quarterfinals. Barry Kitson making something of a dramatic recovery. Started off 11-20, down just a few moments ago. He's pulled back to 15-20, but Ken Strutt needs just this one chalk. Is this the end that he's going to score it on? Now that's the bowl that has possibly qualified to take him through in the quarterfinals against Maureen Bresnan. And if this bowl stays out, as it looks like doing, then Ken Strutt doesn't need to bowl his last one. Indeed it is Ken Strutt who goes forward with perhaps some small trepidation to meet Maureen Bresnan in the quarterfinals, having beaten Barry Kitson 21-15.
Well, Roy, Ken Strutt won't be relishing his next match.
No, he won't, but he's given a very, very cool professional performance, and quietly, he's a very dangerous player. I think Ken could do very, very well.
Rumours that Barry Kitson deliberately tried to lose totally unfounded.
Oh, yes, very much so, yes. Yes. Yeah.
As one of the game's senior statesmen, what's your reaction to what we've seen here today, with Jane Jones going so well early on, and now Maureen Bresnan with that absolutely remarkable victory over Chris McDonald?
Totally unpredictable. Absolutely amazing. The only scenario that could happen now, of course, is that with their success here, who knows, the fellows might be allowed to enter the ladies' tournaments now.
Anyway, it really is Ladies' Day here at the Woodland Hotel in Ellesmere Port. I don't think anything could top Maureen Bresnan's performance, but who knows. Here's the first of the quarterfinals, and there's Jane Jones. Roy, who at the moment, I shouldn't laugh, is 5-0 up against Stan Frith. Now, surely it can't happen again.
5-0, yeah. It's early days, fortunately, and Stan's got time to recover, but he's got to get to grips straight away, hasn't he? And she's in again. It's frightening.
It's worth pointing out that in a previous match, Jane was playing, that she was 11-3 down and came back to win that one. Now she's a different ball game this now, isn't it? You know, she's taken the initiative early on. Maybe a little bit more pressure.
Yes, I think that what they have done, what the ladies have done this particular year, is that they've overcome the enemy that they've always encountered, which is nerves. And the further that she goes, of course, she'll find it better. And if she goes in front, it is a case of holding a nerve. Keep that concentration going. But she's up against a Cheshire champion. He's a real brilliant player, Stan. He is one of the two best players in Cheshire. A great thinker about the game. Once he gets the jack, He'll make it difficult for Jane, but of course he's got to get the jack.
Is he the type, Roy, who will be able to withstand this very different sort of pressure, because all the money will be on Jane. The crowd, as we saw with Maureen, will be right behind Jane. Now, it becomes a question of character rather than ability in situations like this. Now, is Stan the man
to turn it round?
Yes, he is, very much so. Yes, he's a very phlegmatic character. He's been through all these sorts of situations before, certainly not with a lady, but he is the man. Once he gets the jack, I think you'll find that Stan will do some real good work with it.
He's not got it yet. Yes, he has. He's finally got the jack, 6-2. What a great moment then to go over and join Hugh Johns, who will be joined just in a moment or two by Roy.
Thank you, Elton. Well, this has been a really dramatic start to the to this quarter-final. Jane, having won the toss, took the block and promptly stuck six chalks on Stan, and Stan has now just got it back and has set a mark. Well, that jack cannot be more than 10 inches from the ditch, and it's bound to be a short ball that wins this end. Stan's left his first delivery way short. Jane bowling with confidence, perhaps too much confidence. She needs to hit something. It won't stay. No, it won't stay. It needed to hit the block then. So Stan counting one at the moment, because his is the only bowl on the green. And his second is way short again. Now, it's got to be anything, well, a 5-foot, 6-foot bowl. Oh, gosh, that's coming out a fair old speed, surely. There's a great whoa, yes! Just wait for that massive applause to die down. Well, the support for Jane, as great as the support was for Maureen earlier. And Roy, quite honestly, I don't remember broadcasting Crown Bowls live with so much drama as we're having here this afternoon.
It's been absolutely amazing, hasn't it? 7-2, who'd have thought it, you know? And Stanley badly needed to count that end, but look at this lead. It's only about 4 inches off.
Well, I've got a feeling that the odds which started off against Maureen and Jane earlier in the tournament, which were 200-1 to win it, have been dramatically reduced since then.
Certainly, yes. I think before this game, the odds to win the title have come down alarmingly. I think they're about 33-1 now.
Well, look at that little patch of bowls down there. Two sweet bowls from Jane Jones, nestling alongside the little yellow jack, and Stanfrith has got one yellow disc bowl in his hand to try and change it. Got it. No! Didn't get the full contact. Left two. A 7-shot advantage for Jane Jones with that double, the second double that she scored. In fact, she scored, that's 8 ends completed, and she's failed to score on only one. Maureen Bresnan split between her grandchildren and the fascination of what's going out on the green there. Maureen Bresnan shocked everybody earlier, beating Chris McDonald. Can Jane Jones keep up this accuracy? You were staying Roy, that once Stan got the block back, he would be dictating things, but it hasn't happened.
No, I think what happened, Stan sent the jack too near the edge of the green, frightened himself and played two short bowls, and he's paid the penalty for that. In point of fact, there is a difference between the bowls. Jane Jones is playing about 2 pounds, 8 ounce plastic bowls, which is a good weight for a lady. Stan is 3 ounces heavier, playing with wooden bowls, and he's a bit more biased in his bowls, a bit more bent.
Well, he's two down on this end at this moment. Is he going to change it? Got the jack, ran on. Now, who's counting? Mary Ashcroft is the referee. And I noticed that she has blue lollipops in her hand. I wonder if Stan will agree. Well, he's given one.
Jones!
Two! Another double. Doubles back to back. 11-2, Jane Jones. Jane, a very young grandmother with her grandchildren here this afternoon. And that, I think, the very first time in this match that Jane has been wayward with her lead bowl. And Stan's making her pay for that. So she's really got to do some business here. It's looking tidy. Oh, unlucky. She needed to rest on the yellow bowl, didn't. And this leaves the possibility of a double for Stan Frith.
Frith, two.
A double for Stan Frith, who perhaps causes the family of Jane Jones, a sister Pat there, her mother Alice Darwood, daughters, thoroughly enjoying what Jane is doing out on the green. And incidentally, you can see that there are just one or two empty seats here at the Woodlands Hotel, Ellesmere Port. Still time to come on down here and join us as you watch this game live. It's a cool afternoon, but I assure you there is some superb bowling and marvellous excitement here at the Woodlands. Well, Stan the man has got a beauty there. Curly mark, round pegging down the hill. Jane not quite getting the land right. Looking as though it's going to be underneath. And I was wrong, it's bang on the target.
This is a test now, Hugh. Can Jane Jones strike? We'll soon find out.
What is more interesting, can Mary Ashcroft field it? Nope. She missed. Mary stopped it dead. Jane gives
two.
Gives best on that one, and Stan Frith picks up another double, goes on to six, cut the lead to five. Stan Frith, the master of crown bowls, I suppose, looking back to 83 when he won so many titles, the All England Merit, the Waterloo, Embassy Champion of Champions, Bass Northwest Champion, Tetley Classic, everything inside. Here to get to this competition, winning that prestigious Talbot. And he beat Peter Fielding. Stan setting this mark a fair distance. It's a fair lead for a block that's way, way, way across the green. Jane slightly misjudged that. This piece of land, of course, is a slight misjudgment, Roy, and
level.
It just doesn't finish, does it?
It's a very difficult mark, and it's very wise of Stan. I think Stan's a brilliant round peg player. It's about 42 yards, and they're going over one of the two crowns, playing thumb peg, and Stan's strong bowls just whipping a bit at the finish, but I think he's got a two-length bowls.
Well, there seems to be plenty of open space around the jack. And she's certainly stronger with this one. Stop now, or I think she's won that. Yes, she has. Got it absolutely dead right. And the family keeping up with the Joneses is quite something here. They're on every bowl. You can see them. Pat and Alice, Jane's mother, they're riding on every bowl with Jane. 12-6. Now this was a patch of land that Jane was using very, very well earlier in the match, and she's again got a very good lead. Just drops in behind the jack. 18 inches to 2 foot, perhaps. Oh, Stan, I'm sure you're well short. There's a tiny downhill finish on this mark. Now Jane ideally would like to take something off the running of her first bowl, as she has done. Oh, that's excellent bowling. That is great judgment. Creeps, 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 hasn't won it. Probably cut the count. We'll see in a moment. It's definitely one blue. Two. It's two. Well, this surely has got to be a case now of Jane holding her nerve. She's not been as strong as this in front in any of her matches.
She's playing brilliantly, absolutely brilliantly, because what she's doing, when she has a crucial bowl to pull out, she's actually doing it, and that takes a lot of nerve. And she's going now about 40 yards into the heavier part of the green. A good lead here, and Stan's under a whole lot of pressure. The danger signs are looming for Stan Frith.
As Jane has got to keep her nerve now. Her lead was a bit short, but then this is a very long mark. Oh, that's a very handy collision. Things are not going right for Stan the man. He's finding it difficult to keep up with the Joneses. That'll run a bit if it goes down the hill behind the jack. It's counting two, two against him.
That's
Stan asks. It's two against him. If he gives up a two here, he's in real bother. His big heavy bowl past the jack could run on and out. Oh, just pulled up. So, has that saved? Has that won it? The bowls are a fair way from the target, that yellow block.
Okay.
It's between those two.
You want to measure, please.
measuring job for Joe Earns and Roy Bate. And as usual, every time the measure's wanted, they come from the furthest point on the green. This was a difficult block to go to, Roy, that far away. And it's not unusual that they're measuring for a shot which is a bowl a long way back.
I think the problem was the short bowls were in the way. And I think Stan Frith is in here because I could almost hear his sigh of relief from up here when his ball stopped.
You're dead right. 14-7, Jane Jones leads. It's 7-14 off the mat, Stan Frith. And where would you anticipate Stan taking Jane now?
I think Stan will come down finger peg, he'll come round peg, about 35 yards beneath our commentary position where he scored two real good chalks before. He's got this mark off, has to give his bowls about 6 inches more than the jack. It's all uphill.
We
with
don't
a downhill
mind
finish.
Shouting, but not when they're delivering the bowls.
Well, we're delighted to have Maureen Bresnan up here in the box with her. What do you think of Jane's performance so far, Maureen?
She's bowling very well indeed, and she's just keeping her head and bowling the green, which is what you've got to do. Stan's a superb bowler, but if she can just bowl the green, she'll be all right.
And she's pushed that out on a large piece of land.
She's got the legs. It's on beautiful land. Just given up.
Stan with some improving to do on his first bowl. Lovely curving arc. Now, Maureen, need a yard and a half of running on this bowl as opposed to the first one. The land is too far out, it won't come back from there.
No.
And in fact it could be two
it
against
her. It is two,
her.
Yes.
Three, two.
There's some worried faces amongst them. Pat Davis there, her sister, and her mother Alice, wearing the glasses. It was all brightness and life a few moments ago, but there's some worried faces there now. How much has the tension affected you as a bowler, and what do you think it's doing to Jane down there?
The atmosphere has been absolutely wonderful. Cheering for the ladies, I think it's been a little bit biased for us, and it seems to have helped us a little bit. It certainly helped me, and we just want to get as far as we can and bowl as well as we can.
As a matter of fact, Hugh, Stan has just made a request to Mary Ashcroft to request the crowd not to shout when he's delivering his bowl. I think most of the players, all the top players, they don't mind how much people shout as long as they don't do it just when they're about to deliver the bowl.
Got a good wood here.
Oh, that's a good bowl, resting on the blue bowl and counting. Now, Jane. She did well on this piece of land before. That is not going to finish. It's not going to change anything.
It's a length wood, that, Hugh.
Well, I am totally wrong.
Yes.
Good gracious me. From here, it looked as though, well, from my position, it didn't look right. But Jane knew it, Maureen knew it, and the crowd certainly applauded it. A single. 15-9. Well, Roy, we could never really... I mean, we're so delighted about what Maureen has done and delirious about the excitement we got from that game, but we could never believe that Stan Frith would be this far behind this early in the match.
No, I never believed that lightning could strike three times, but at 15-9, look at this, it's there to happen, isn't it? And I think that Stan, if he gets the jack again, he's got to adopt some different tactics. His three-quarter corners have not worked. But can he get the jack?
Well, honestly, for live entertainment on television on a Saturday afternoon, I think you'd go through many, many months before you'd find anything to equal what we've had here this afternoon and what we're continuing to have. Touched the jack, ran about a yard through. Now this is looking as though it's won it.
Yes.
Yep. Certain amount of relief showing on Stanforth's face. A single takes him on to 10. Five behind Jane Jones. Now, Stan, when he came this way once before, as you were saying, Roy, frightened himself half to death by sticking the block right on the edge of the green.
Yes, he's corrected it this time. He's actually just on top of the lip. There is a lip across each of the three corners. Anything past the jack, it'll go about a yard. And I think he's got a good ball coming here.
Yes.
Especially if he touches the jack. That's brilliant.
That's going to take some beating. Bias on the bowl towards the ditch, coming down with the slope, creeping a little bit. Well, I think it's a good second bowl. Just pulled up short, so he's only counting one.
She might have a go at that.
She has signaled that she's going to have a strike,
yeah.
And our cameraman is likely to lose his lens. So he moves out the way, and she comes with a little bit of weight, turning the bowl over, and it won't come back. So that's a single to Stanforth. He goes on to 11, Jane's on 15, and we shall still have activity live here from the Woodlands when you rejoin us.
A great 24-page soccer fixtures guide for England, Wales and Scotland, plus the international matches. Also, your personal lottery number could win you fabulous prizes. Plus, in the big free magazine, superstar Bruce Willis talks about life, wife Demi Moore and his fears for their children. Every kind of people, your kind of people. Only in The People. Buy it on Sunday.
RAC, how can we help you?
Choosing a toothpaste for your family can be a bit of a puzzle. With regular brushing, most toothpastes fight decay. Some fight tartar, but that's where most toothpastes stop. You can complete the puzzle with an antibacterial agent that also helps to protect gums. Now there's new Ultra Protection Crest to look after your family's teeth and gums. New Ultra Protection Crest. No toothpaste, gives more complete protection.
Nice to see you again. Oh, yes. Hasn't time flown?
Yes, it stood still for you. I have grey hair. You're not grey at all, are you?
That's because I look after myself. I discovered Just for Men. Simply apply, wait 5 minutes and rinse off. Grey hairs just disappear. With Just for Men, no grey, just natural looking colour.
Your husband is so young looking. Are you sure he and my Harry went to school together?
Just for Men gets rid of the grey in just 5 minutes.
When you left us, it was 15:11 to Jane Jones. Now you're back here again live at the Woodlands. We've had two ends of bowls. Both of them have scored a single, and you can see the scoreboard there. It's 16:12 to Jane Jones. And she's slightly lost her way on this particular end.
Little touch of nerves, I think. Better.
Stan bringing this down the hill, dropping in for what is certainly one. And they'll wait for Stan to come up to decide whether it's more than one. The basic rules of this game in the deciding of who's got what, it's down to the players. If they cannot decide, then it's down to measurement. It was a single. It's 13-16 off the mat, Stan Frith. And with me, as we had before the break, Maureen Bresnan, who has created her own piece of history here this afternoon. Tactically, do you think Jane is playing it the right way?
Yes, I think so. She's just got to disturb Stan's length, because I think if Stan gets his own length, he can put up superb woods.
Question is, what is Stan's length? I mean, he is an absolutely first-class round peg, block bowler, but then he can take them on in the corners as well.
Yes, yes. But if he can keep putting a good lead up, with both of them, it's all about the lead. All about putting the lead there.
Jane seems to have lost her length a little bit now.
She might be getting a bit nervous.
Stan, another good load here. Right road, right weight, holding two.
Well, this has got the legs.
This has got chances.
Yes.
If it comes down the hill.
It's got the legs.
Keep running.
Just giving up.
No, I think that's two.
Yes.
And if it is, then the gap between them is only one.
Three, two.
It is two. And Stan Frith, who was 14-6 down at one stage, has pulled himself back 15-16 off the mat. And he's now taking Jane all around the park. Finger peg up over the crown and using the slope on the other side to complement the bias.
He's short.
He's very short. Now this is a length that Jane has bowled particularly well throughout this bass tournament. Now the yellow ball got in the way. I would think think that the blue ball might be closest.
Just like yours, there's not much in them, Stan.
No, I think the yellow ball's straight to the jack.
It's yours for the jack.
Stan wants to go and have a look.
You've got a bigger ball, it's hard to say. Just like yours, yeah.
Mary Ashcroft saying you've got a big bowl, which is true enough, of course. Stan's fairly hefty 212s, considerably bigger than Jane's 2.8s, 2 pound 8 ounce bowls.
Jane's right in his way now, though.
Yes.
Yes, he's had to turn the peg.
Turned his bowl over. So the bias now is towards the slope.
And Jane will follow him
in. And, oh, right on the button.
Yes.
Didn't he judge that well?
I think Jane will follow him in.
Yes, Jane going on the same road.
No, she's falling away.
No, she's going to drop down underneath. It won't come back. Well, it's definitely one.
It's only one.
And Stan picks his bowl up and says, one it is. And so, after the 23rd end of this highly dramatic match, we're level at 16 across. And I would think now in the back end, it's very much down to Jane's concentration, determination, ability to keep her nerve.
Yes. Yes, yes, she's got to keep her nerve now and just make sure that she's gets her bowls out straight and true. She's under great pressure now that he's caught up to 16 across. I think Jane can do it. I'm sure she can. But it's very difficult on there. Actually, I think it's worse watching. Well, she's got room. It's a yard short.
How much would the money be on her mind at this moment, Maureen? Because...
Not at the moment. Not while she's bowling, I don't think. But obviously, it's very nice. Oh, she's coming in beautifully here. Beautiful length wood. Superb.
Well, now that is going to take a lot of beating. And if she gets the block back in her fingers at this stage
of
the game...
Yes, he's not coming. He's not coming. He's short.
Now, Jane, can you remember exactly what you did just a moment ago? Can you find exactly that same line and
weight? Well, she's put it out, right? She might just be a bit low this time. Yes, and a bit short.
Yes.
Yes. I don't think the money has a lot to do with it, Hugh. It's a lot of it is the prestige of bowling against the men. It's a lovely feeling to be bowling good bowls against the men. The men seem to bring... they are good bowlers, the men, and they do bring out the best in the women bowlers. I thoroughly enjoy playing with the men, and it gives you great experience.
I was going to say, how much previous experience against men have you had, Maureen?
Oh,
a great deal?
Yes, yes. I've played them around the Chester area, played a lot... and played a lot of good bowlers.
But perhaps never with as much concentration on you as this.
No, no, not the pressure that's on here. It's absolutely fantastic. But Jane's the same as me. It seems to bring out the best in you.
Indeed.
You can just hang on to it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes, he can't get past the wood.
Jane. Determined look in her eye.
Well, she's got a good speed there, I think. No, it's not going.
No, it's not
going. No, it's not
there.
Going. Lovely land. Lovely land.
Now, how much improvement can Stan get?
Well, if it can get past Jane's wood.
It's on course.
Yes, yes, it's a good wood.
It's a beauty. Bold. Well bowled, Stan.
Three.
17 across. And Alice can hardly bear to watch. That's her mother. She really can't. She has a quick look up. Her fingers almost in prayer. Mm. Jane, her sister, thoughtful alongside her.
Pat.
Pat, rather, mm-hmm. Pat.
Pat said she'd sooner play than watch.
Stan again, sending that one a long way out into the corner down below us. That's about 6-8 feet from the ditch.
He's got to put good leads up, otherwise Jane will step in. He hasn't put a good lead up.
No.
She'll step in.
Jane must judge the weight very carefully here. She won't want to be too fast, otherwise she'll
got a good
run
wood.
Fast.
She's got a good wood. Bold.
Yes. Almost tossing a challenge down.
The blue bolt's a foot behind. It's only a little yard short.
Jane throwing down a challenge to Stan. Beat that, she says.
He's not pegging.
No.
Not pegging.
It stood up at the back end of the travel. Great chance for two.
You got the length then.
I think she's tight this time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Whoa, whoa. A touch on the block would do.
She might be two.
It is two. Stan's looking very, very closely at it. He's certainly
measured.
Mm.
Joe Owens, Roy Bate coming out again. Jane watches anxiously from one side and reflective, sucking in the cheeks. Stan,
well,
never thought, I'm sure, when he started this match, that it would be